I've been doing art for pretty much my entire life. Just for reference, I'm 20. So let's say roughly 18 years I'm doing art. And I've never painted on canvas, so I would like to take a moment to try and change that. Hello, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're doing well. Yes, it is true, never painted on a canvas, but I somehow own a lot of them. I don't know how I ended up owning so many canvases. But I wanted to try and paint on a canvas just to see how different it is, see if I liked it. I'd say overall, I had a pretty good experience. But I was definitely way out of my element. Also, I originally had plans to make this into sort of like a sketch vlog type of thing, but the cord to my microphone needs to be plugged in to like a computer or a laptop or something, and it's not long enough to reach onto my desk. Onto my drawing desk, I mean. I have two separate desks for like drawing and computer work stuff. So I originally used my old laptop to record audio, but my sister needs it for online schooling. So I'm currently looking into getting like an external microphone. I don't know what the proper name is, but a microphone that doesn't need to be plugged in. So looking into that, don't worry. I actually had a lot of sketch vlogs planned for this month. If you have any suggestions, let me know. I'd definitely love to hear it. So I tried to figure out I tried to look up advice specifically for painting on canvases, but I couldn't really find any. The biggest thing that I saw was just to prime your canvas. Some canvases come like pre-primed, but if they don't, then you should put a layer of gesso on it, which I did. I even went out and got some gesso. So I was really trying hard. I primed the canvas off camera. I did it before, a couple days before actually I ended up filming. So it was already ready to go by the time I started filming this, which also, was I supposed to sketch and then prime or prime and then sketch? Because I primed and then sketched, but I didn't know at what point I should prime, but that's what I did. Let me know if that was wrong and I'm an idiot. But anyways, I didn't know what to paint on this canvas for about a week. I was just staring at it, not knowing what I was going to put on it. But I was like, hey, people paint their pets, right? Let me paint my dog. I picked up this picture of my dog, which I think overall it's a nice picture, but then she's just side-eyeing the camera really hard. And I think it was funny. So I thought it would make a nice painting. The first thing I noticed right off the bat is that sketching on a canvas was very different from sketching on anything else. I guess like the most textured thing I've sketched on before this canvas was like watercolor paper, but it was so different. I definitely think the fact that I primed it also added to the texture. But for anybody wondering why you need to put gesso on it, I still am not completely sure about it myself, but from what I understand, if you don't prime your canvas, it makes your paints less opaque and it makes them seep into the canvas a little bit more. And so the gesso helps give it something to grip onto and makes it not absorb. I don't know if that's right. If you're a painter, let me know. Again, let me know if I'm just an idiot, but a lot of people were just saying to prime your canvas, and so I was like, okay. But that definitely made the sketching really weird. I also noticed that the pencil smears a lot easier. But in terms of actually sketching my dog, I didn't really have any other issues. Like, I didn't have any issues with the picture itself. I sketched it pretty okay. I think some of the proportions are slightly off, but like, I mean, it still looks like my dog. So that's a win. It just doesn't look exactly like the picture. Another thing that I couldn't really get a hold of is how detailed I should make the sketch, because obviously since I was going to be using acrylic paint, it would cover up most of that anyway. So I didn't know how much I should do. Obviously I wasn't going to be adding like strands of fur and stuff like that, but I don't know. I honestly think I spent a little bit too much time on the sketch. I probably could have saved myself a little bit of time, but overall I wasn't, it didn't take too long, maybe like 30 minutes. After I sketched it out, I put it on a little tabletop easel that I got. I figured, I mean, this is what people do, right? This is how you paint. On an easel. Like I said, I haven't painted on a canvas before, but I have painted other like larger pieces, and I made the mistake those times of not painting a background first, so I did that. The background wasn't anything too complicated. I just took this like coral pink color of acrylic paint that I had, and I squirted it out right out of the tube. I didn't mix it with anything, and I put that as the background color. And then later on I add a little like a stroke effect, I guess, I don't know, what do you call things? But I added that around the dog, but that comes much later. That was like the last thing I did. And then honestly, just from there, I just kind of went for it. Not only was I just out of my element, but I also feel like I don't really have a process for acrylic paints. I just kind of go for it. I will say though, that painting with acrylic paints tends to be a lot harder for me. Honestly, even just with watercolor, I have the same issue, but I need to let the paint dry. I do some after I put down a base layer of color, I do a little bit of blending just with like some different tones just to have them all mesh together, and then I'll add in the finer details on top of that. But like, I need to remember to let that first layer dry, because then when I go and add the finer details, everything just blends together and it's a mess. But I definitely think the proportions in my sketch were a lot more accurate than what they ended up being. I think after I just started layering more and more paint on top and my sketch started to fade, I kind of forgot what the proportions were, so I kind of just guessed. But again, it still looks like my dog. It doesn't look exactly like the picture. I also had a little bit of a hard time finding the right colors. I should have scripted this video, but mixing the right colors. I had a hard time mixing the right colors because my dog's fur is kind of like pretty specific. This picture is a little bit more on the overexposed side, I guess. So her fur looks a lot more white, and she does have a lot of white fur on her, but she also has like a creamy color to her, and she has a lot of brown patches, and they're like, the brown patches on her are kind of more yellow than what they ended up being in the painting, but also I couldn't find the right amount of yellow to add, because even if I just added a teeny tiny drop of yellow, everything would be hella yellow. And so I was like, okay, what if I added like a pink or a red, but then that just made it pink or red. So I don't know what to do. I even tried mixing like orange, because I don't have a tube of orange paint, but I tried making an orange and then adding that to like the white, which didn't work, and then I added it to like a burnt sienna, but then that didn't work. So I don't know what I was doing. So, I mean, I guess it was good practice in trying to mix colors, so that's, I tried. Another thing that I'd like to point out is that I actually didn't use any black paint in here. I don't remember, I think it was from a TikTok, but I heard a really helpful tip is to replace your black paint with a Payne's Gray paint, because black is like such a harsh color, but then Payne's Gray, obviously like the darker parts, they kind of trick your eye into making it think it's black, but it's more rich than a black. It's not like an exact black. And then when you mix it to make grays, and just it adds a little bit more depth to your painting, I think. I think it turns out better than if I had used black. And so I used the Payne's Gray for the nose, the little snout mouth area, and then like the area around her eyes, and then she has a couple of black streaks in her ear. I also mixed it in with the fur color I had to add a little bit of shading, but this was only within certain areas. Like within the picture where I saw parts that looked a little bit cooler, I would shade with that Payne's Gray, but other than that, I would just shade with like a darker brown that had like reds and stuff in it. There's a part of me that kind of wishes I picked a picture of her that didn't have her wearing the scarf. So I think the picture of her looks, like I think the painting of her, like the parts of her, of the painting, I think that part looks fine, and then I think the scarf looks fine, but I don't think they really look like they go together. Like, I don't know, they just seem a little separate, and like, there's a part of her in the picture where her fur is kind of going over the scarf, which, by the way, this is a little tangent, but I feel like I need to say it. I know the scarf is, it's complete, it has no functional purpose. I highly doubt it keeps her warm, but truth be told, are you a pet owner, specifically a dog owner, if you don't buy pointless shit like this? I saw a scarf and I said, hey, she needs a scarf. I don't know why, but I just feel like she needs a scarf, so she has a scarf now. But anyways, there's definitely a lot of parts that, like, of the scarf where it feels like it's not on her, I guess. And I feel like a big part of that is because it's plaid. I feel like if it was just a solid color, I would be able to shade it more and make it look more like it's a part of her, I guess. But I think for the most part, it just looks like it's slapped on, which, I mean, to be fair, kind of is. It was the last thing that I did, mostly because it's like, since it's wrapped around her neck, it would be on top of everything. Then after I let the scarf dry, I did go over and add like those little tufts of fur going on top of the scarf. But yeah, the scarf was definitely my least favorite part of this. So I guess my favorite part, I really liked drawing the, like, painting the snout part. I really, really liked that. I thought that it was just so fun with, like, her skin color underneath, like, around her lips, and then making the nose, and then having the tiny, tiny strands of fur go on top of that. And then, of course, her mustache, her glorious mustache. And then her little teeth just subtly poking. I thought it was really cute. And then I'm really happy with the eye, too. I think the eye came out pretty nice. I think another part of me that really struggles with acrylic paint is, like, deciding when a painting is done. When it comes to traditional medium, right, like, I work mostly with Copic markers. Like, I would say that's my main traditional medium. And I think that with Copic markers, there's a lot more of, like, that this drawing is finished now. Like, there's nothing more I can do because it's like, we have the sketch and then we have the line art. And then after the line art is on, you can't really change the silhouette of anything. You can't really change where certain things are put. The same thing with the actual markers themselves. Like, once you put something there, it's there. And of course you can layer, but they are generally transparent. So if you put a lighter color on top of a darker color, that's that. Like, you won't see it. That darker color is just there. But then with acrylic paints, like, since it's opaque, you can layer lighter colors on top of darker colors, which allows for a lot more changing. Like, the size of the eye changed a lot. Like, the eye is actually supposed to be bigger, but the more I painted, like, around that area, the smaller it got. And I would say the opposite happened with the nose. Like, the more I painted the nose, the larger it got. And that's because of, like, the opacity of the paint. Like, it's super opaque. It changes that aspect of art. When it comes to other mediums, I'm a lot better at saying a drawing is finished, but for this one, it was definitely, like, even now looking at it, I see things that can be changed, but at some point I just had to be like, nope, you're done. This is it. That was just, it's something that I'm gonna have to get used to, I guess, if I'm going to be working with acrylic paint, because, oh man. And then, of course, like I said, after I finished the actual painting itself, I added this sort of stroke effect. I used that same pink color I used in the background, and then I mixed that in with a tube of magenta paint to get this, like, almost magenta color, like a darker pink color. At first, I was just going to do, like, a solid, like, outline of it, but then after I put down the darker color, I didn't really like how it looked, and so I mixed a mid-tone and kind of, like, blended those out, and then I used, like, the just straddle the tube again, the pink color, to help make it fade into the background. I don't know why that was so hard. But yeah, that's my dog, that's my baby. What do you think, Zola? Do you like the painting? Do you like the painting? She's just looking at me. Okay, well.
Zola, look, it's you. It's you. Do you like it? Do you like it? Does it look like you? Here, look. Do you like it?
I know, you can't eat it, so you're upset.
Look.
No.
Okay, rude. You're so cute, I love you. I love you. I love you.
Another thing, I also have three other smelly trash babies that I would like to paint. So I would like to paint them on canvases too and make them like a set of four. So if you want to see those in future videos, let me know. I'd definitely be down to show you guys. It would also give me an opportunity to practice with acrylic paint. So give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. If you want to see more of that, this is my dog Zola. I have three cats to paint, so let me know if you want to see that. And also, if you have any tips for acrylic paint, if you have any tips for acrylic paint, please let me know. I would still consider myself a noob at acrylic paint. I don't really know what I'm doing. Like I said, I don't really have a process. And if you like this painting or if you like this dog, consider giving this video a thumbs up and subscribing. I don't know if that was a sentence, but we'll just move on. My name is Oliver and I post a lot of art here. So if you are new here, I would really, really appreciate it if you could subscribe. As of recording this, we are just under 90,000, which is insane. So thank you so much for all the support. Let's get to it. And you can also follow me on social media, which will be on screen now and linked in the description box below. I'm most active on Instagram, so I would recommend following me there, but if not, then don't worry about it. And there will also be some videos on screen now and linked in the iCard for you to check out if you want. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye!